Five Americans land in Qatar as part of a prisoner swap for five Iranians held in the U.S. The rare deal between the two countries also unfreezes some $6 billion of Iran's funds, and three of the five freed Americans have been in prison for more than 5 years. It was unclear if the exchange would bring progress on the many issues that divide the two nations. Now the U.S. has branded Iran as a sponsor of terrorism, while Tehran calls Washington the great Satan.
President Biden has demonstrated that he's prepared to make tough and difficult decisions. I have no higher priority. The president has no higher priority than making sure that Americans who are unjustly detained anywhere can come home. This process and the engagements necessary to bring it about, the freedom of these unjustly detained Americans, has always been a separate track in our engagement, or for that matter, lack of engagement with Iran. So irrespective of what was happening or not happening, for example, in pursuing the effort to return to the nuclear agreement, we've been focused on working independently to bring these Americans home. So it doesn't speak to anything else in the relationship.
Protests erupt in Libya a week after deadly floods swept the city of Derna. Hundreds of demonstrators are demanding accountability over the chaotic response to the disaster. They are also accusing authorities of neglect, with Libya's parliament speaker calling the floods fake. Last week's torrential rains burst two dams, unleashing a catastrophe that killed thousands and left thousands too, or missing. Now, Libya has two governments, an internationally recognized one based in Tripoli, and a region administered separately in the east, where Derna is located. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, DJ Manoto.
Good morning, Nikki. Here are the top stories making headlines amongst the Filipino community. We begin with House Republicans launching a probe into the Biden administration's response to the Maui fires in August.
House Oversight and Accountability Chairman James Comer, a Republican from Kentucky, announced the investigation into the Federal Emergency Management Agency's handling of the deadliest wildfire in modern U.S. history. Comer announced the probe in a joint press release with Republican Representative Pete Sessions of Texas, who heads the Subcommittee on Government Operations and the Federal Workforce. The committee said the Biden administration failed to deliver the appropriate response when it mattered most, and that there are many serious problems still unanswered. Many Hawaiians have also criticized the Biden administration's timing of the disaster response, the amount of aid given to the victims, and the so-called lack of transparency from FEMA.
Still in Maui, the death toll from the Lahaina blaze has dropped after weeks of DNA review.
Hawaii authorities say the death toll from the Lahaina wildfire has dropped from 115 to 97. This drop in numbers comes after forensics tests recognized duplicates in a catalog of remains. Officials have shared that this can happen when multiple agencies are contributing towards recovery efforts. One Oahu Filipino who helped in organizing a list of donation links for those affected by the Maui wildfires shared her sadness over the many lives lost.
Anytime a death is announced from the news or from the government, it's hard to process. It's hard to think that many people have been affected. How many families lives have been lost from this?
At least 14 of those who died are of Filipino ethnicity, with four being Philippine passport holders.
According to the consulate's records, we have four among the fatalities who renewed their passports here at the Philippine consulate in Hawaii. There's one other who has been naturalized as a U.S. citizen, and there must be about half a dozen where online information appeared indicating that they have ties to the Philippines. We found that many of them are U.S. citizens already, immigrants or maybe even second, third generation immigrants.
Of the 97 fatalities, 74 people have been officially identified. Authorities add that the number of missing has dropped to 31.
And finally, in sports, we head to California, where Filipino boxer Mercito No Mercy Hesta suffered a six-round loss to Mexican fighter William Zepeda.
A big Mexican Independence Day victory for rising Mexican star William Zepeda, scoring a 6-round knockout win over Filipino fighter Mercedo No Mercy Hesta at the main event for this past weekend's Golden Boy on the Zone card. From the second round onwards, the undefeated Zepeda pressured Hesta, backing him to the ropes to unload combinations. At the 131 mark of the 6th round, referee Jack Reese and Mercedo's corner nearly simultaneously called for a halt to the fight, giving the Mandawi fighter his second career knockout loss. The 27-year-old Zepeda improved his record to an undefeated 29 wins with 25 knockouts.
He's a tough, young, hungry warrior, and I gave my all over there. There's no excuse. He's the best man tonight.
And those are the top stories making the headlines amongst the Filipino community. You can catch more of our TFC News on our website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News, on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel and the ABS-CBN News app on your smartphones and tablets. Back to Nikki for the rundown.